Ahead, a new relationship and sex curriculum is set to come into force from September next year, which will require primary schools to teach about different families and secondary schools to teach about sexual orientation and gender identity. That's the background. Let's turn to one of the protesters, indeed, protest coordinator Shakil Afsar for the Anderton Park Primary School in Birmingham, who joins me now. What do you have planned for later today with your colleagues? Good morning.
Good morning. After several weeks and weeks of having no clear consultation with the school and no real age appropriateness taken into account, parents have been left with no other alternative but to protest. We've tried numerous avenues to try to talk to this head teacher. And as you said, it's only two schools that have been very explosive. These same two schools' head teachers are best of friends. And the parents at both schools are complaining of exactly the same thing. Lack of consultation, lack of age appropriateness.
How do you know? Yeah. How do you know, Mr. Afsar, that there is a lack of age appropriateness?
Well, when my sister comes to me on numerous times and says that her child, who's 3 years old, has been given a book such as King and King and The Princess Boy, unfortunately, this is not according to her religious beliefs, is not in line with what she wants her child to learn at that age, and she feels that her child is not ready to absorb this sort of information because it's contradictory to what he's being taught at home.
And briefly, what is the story of Princess Boy then?
Well, it's about a young boy who likes to dress up in dress. It's basically about a transgender. And we, unfortunately, teach our children, at that age, about male and female. Not that men want to become women and women want to become men, because that's not in line with our religious and moral footings. And that aside, parents have still said we are willing for our children to learn about the different societies that exist with the consultations with the parents and also bearing in mind age appropriateness. But that has not been taken into account in neither of these schools.
And you mentioned your faith. I'm assuming you're a Muslim. You don't have to confirm or deny. But where is Islam as regards transgender people? Is there a relaxation with your faith?
Well, look, whether I've actually started to say I'm Christian, Jewish,
I'm
and
sorry,
Muslim,
I apologize.
I know I'm all three religions because.
Oh, I see. Right.
Yeah, so because the simple fact of the matter is where I come from and the subcontinent, we actually have laws that protect transgender people. So I originate from Kashmir in the Asian subcontinent.
I see.
We actually have laws that protect transgender people. And in our communities, we have utmost respect. But what we will not tolerate is our children being taught at that age that a boy can change its gender into a girl.
I was just interested in what you said, that these books are contrary, and I'm just going to quote you back, contrary to what's being taught at home. Well, what is being taught at home with these young children as regards transgender?
In our Christian values, in our Jewish values, and in our Muslim values, homosexual relationship or a trans somebody wanting to be a transgender is not a morally permissible relationship to have. It's contradicting what the children learn in Sunday church. It's contradicting what they learn in the Torah. It's contradicting what they learn in the Quran. And what we are saying is we understand that parents don't have a right to veto this education, but why were parents not consulted? Why were children sent home with books, such as the ones I've mentioned, without any consultation? Now, these are people who are of extreme faith. They pray five times a day, some of them, and the children have been sent home with books without any collective consultation because, unfortunately, the head teacher is on a pro-LGBT campaign when she should be on a pro-All Nine Equalities Act campaign.
All
but
right.
That's what she's doing.
Stay on the line. She's not here to defend herself, so we'll perhaps move to broader areas. Please stay with us if you can, Mr. Afsar. I want to bring into the conversation now Karkan Qureshi, who is a Muslim LGBT activist and founder of Finding a Voice. What would you say to one of the key protest coordinators? Good morning to you.
Good morning. What I would say is that these protests really need to stop because, one is, I don't know why he's holding them on a Friday, which is supposed to be the Muslim holiest day of the week. It's our Sabbath. And so, you know, that's contradiction in terms because he's saying he's peaceful and he's tolerant of everybody. But to do it on a Friday of all days, you know, it's a contradiction in terms. With regards to the books, My Princess Boy, it's nowhere does it mention that it's about transgender. What it is a woman celebrating and educating people about her little child who happened to be a boy who likes to wear dresses. There is no mention of trans at all. And with regards to LGBT equality, and why not? We've been living under Section 28 for so many years, which is only abolished 16 years ago. So in terms of equality and moving forward, it's only in the last 15 or 16 years that same-sex people have gained equality rights and human rights, and we need to be moving forward now. I think what Shaquille is doing with his school and the community is provoking people himself. He's got some kind of agenda against Sarah Hewitt-Clarkson, who is the head teacher over at Anderton, and simply because she doesn't allow him to come into the school and demand and dictate the terms and conditions of what they can and cannot teach.
Well, let's put
in a democracy such as the UK, right, we should be allowed to express ourselves how we want to, and also to have the freedoms to have representation in books, whether it's LGB or T and otherwise.
Well,
there are now people who are identifying.
I will come back to you, but you, Mr. Qureshi, you must allow some response. Mr. Afsar, first off, why are you holding it on a Friday? That would appear to be wrong.
I think this gentleman actually is an LGBT activist who I've met numerous times, and to be quite honest with you, he has more input in our children's education than we do. He's constantly in the office with the head teacher, and
come back to you, Mr. Qureshi. Go ahead, Mr. Afsar.
Why we held the protest on Friday is, one, because we've done it towards the end of the week. He fails to tell you that our protests don't start till 3:20, which is only 10 minutes of the school period, which it starts. Our protests have never been held earlier. Thirdly, I'd like to say this man has no children.
Does that disqualify him from having a view?
No, I'm not saying it disqualifies him, but how can he really understand? I'm a father of two daughters. Mm. How can someone who has no children actually be able to understand parental concerns? And then he says that I've got some issue with Sarah Hewitt-Clarkson. I've never had an issue with the head teacher.
So all your colleagues who protest, they're all parents, are they?
They're all, naturally, we've always focused our campaign around
the people who will be joining you this afternoon, they're all mothers and
They'll all be parents. The majority of them will be parents.
The majority. Will not.
No. You have, like, for example, you have some people who are due to become parents.
I will come back to you, Mr. Afsar. I have got to referee this as much as I can. Mr. Qureshi, back to you to come give you a chance to respond. Mr. Qureshi.
Well, first of all, I haven't met Sarah numerous times in the office, as Shaquille has quoted. I've met her once. That was back in the early days. And I've also met Shaquille on several previous occasions. One was in the TV studio and a couple of other times. So, you know, I really wish he would stop this exaggeration and misinformation. With regards to not having children, if somebody does not have a children, it doesn't stop them from having concerns about what is and isn't being taught in a school. Because at the end of the day, we are looking at the well-being and welfare of children and seeing how whether or not they're progressing and developing as individuals so that they're better equipped to tackle the issues that they are surrounded within society today. You know, what we're looking for is children to be understanding and realise that there are diverse individuals within society.
Well, let's put that to Mr.
What makes you think that we don't teach our children that, though? What makes you think that Muslim people, Jewish people don't teach their children to be understanding?
You did ask Mr. Qureshi a question. Let's hear the response. Mr. Qureshi.
As you quite rightly said, Shaquille, in the home, we are taught different things. And I know from personal experience and from talking to other Muslim LGBT that we are brought up under the indoctrination and the concern of homosexuality is haram. And the story of Lut, which referenced homosexuality acts apparently, which, you know, has been misinterpreted and corrupted over the years and the centuries.
Can you honestly tell me, Mr. Afsar, you're confident that all the children at this school and both schools are having some form of teaching regarding these matters at home? You can honestly tell me that.
Well, no. Look, no, we are. Yeah, of course.
Can't,
From childhood, I never had no LGBT lessons. From childhood, my mother and father taught me to respect all human beings for human beings, regardless of their color, regardless of their sexual orientation. What's actually happening here is people like Mr. Kakan have got their rights here and are allowed to live here as normal citizens and not be discriminated. But what they want now is they want us to physically say we accept what they're doing is okay. I don't need to say that a man who's in a homosexual relationship, that's morally valid. Yes, I must not discriminate against him. He must be allowed to live here. But why should I have to say physically and verbally, and why should my children have to verbally affirm that a transgender person or a homosexual relationship is a morally acceptable one when my child's religious grounds don't allow it?
So it's unacceptable to you then?
According to my religion, being in a homosexual relationship is not morally valid.
Bringing it back to the school,
yeah. Why it's become so explosive is because the head teacher, rather than talking to parents, she would rather call people like Kakan Qureshi, people like Farhan Khan, and other LGBT activists into the school and post that on her Twitter, and rather than talk to parents.
Okay, final word to you, Mr. Qureshi.
As I said, I wish that Shaquille would stop sending out this misinformation and fake news, because it's not Sarah inviting us in. We chose of our own prerogative to go into the school to see what was going on, to try and understand the basis of their protest. And to me, it says that with Shaquille going on and on, you know, this has been going on for 9 months now, what he is doing is alienating the Muslim community, specifically from that area of Alum Rock, Spark Hill and Moseley.
I will leave it there.